Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. As promised, there's an update from the mom of the three boys who are being severely abused in Arizona. I'm going to link you to the other videos of information I put out on this, but I want to read a letter to you and again encourage all of you to get behind Paula Flow, get behind protecting these kids, and share this information. Tuesday, April 4th, 2013, my son Romeo Riley had stated that his penis was sore when I tried to pick him up before he went in to start the visit at Aviva, location for family visits provided by CPS. Romeo always states and most of the times cries to me as soon as we start our visit saying, "Mommy, I'm so hungry, let's go eat." Romeo has went into numerous rages also when he visits at Aviva on Tuesdays and Fridays saying, "Mom, I want something to eat right now, right now." I would walk fast as I could to the kitchen and tell him, "Mommy is going to fix you some food as fast as I can, sweetheart." That would soothe him while I hug him and show him the different variations of food I always bring for Romeo and his brothers, Love and Emmanuel. He would eat extremely fast, most of the time packing his mouth with his jaws bulging out. Then I would have him tell him to slow down. Then he would say, "I can take some, Mommy." Then I would say yes and give him some extra food. Romeo would shove it away, saying, "My house parent Mimi will throw my food away, just being mean to me and won't let me eat anything unless it's a little piece of bread or food with hot sauce and no water. Mimi hates me, Mommy." Then he would start crying. I would just hold Romeo and let him know to pray for those who persecute you, and Jesus loves you, so he does everyone else, sweetheart. "I love you, Romeo. Always, son," is what I told him. Then Romeo stated April 19th, 2013, at Aviva during our visit that we started a few minutes earlier. Romeo stated someone in the house stuck a needle in his arm. When I asked who, he said, "I think my friend who was at my house," then shrugged his shoulders saying, "I don't remember, Mommy. I don't know, but it hurted me." All I could do was comfort him and try to encourage him saying, "Romeo, you are such a great person," by showing him that I love him and support him, and to keep hope alive that this situation is going to come to an end, and that he has an Auntie Flo that loves him very much and is coming to help get him out of the horrible situation. He smiled and kissed me on my cheek, and I said, "I miss and love you, Mommy, and I'm supposed to have my brothers here with me. Why they keep being away from me?" And again, folks, the children were supposed to be kept together. They were taken from the mom illegally. It's bullshit. You can look into the background on that on the other videos, and the children are supposed to be kept together, and since the mother has exposed pictures and the boy has made statements, they've separated the children so that the little boy is not protected by his older siblings. So we've got to act on this. We've got to call attention to this. Finish the letter here. Romeo was in the car leaving. Romeo looked as though, "Well, here I go back to a terrible place again," and he looked so scared, yet trying to look strong for his mommy, saying in his mind, "Mommy, I can take it as long as I get to see my mommy." That is the same statement Love and Emmanuel gave to me also. "Mother, it doesn't matter how much they torture, persecute, and do nasty, terrible things to us. As long as we get to see you, Mama, that's all we need." So anyway, folks, that's the update. We've got to act on this. And for you, Sunshine Residential Group, you damn well better expect us. You're a horrible, vile, disgusting institution. And me and others will not rest until your doors are closed and justice is served and these children are released. Much love, many thanks, and I'll see you soon.